Alright, what's going on everyone? Welcome back to another video. Fellas, today we're gonna be taking a look at something. I really don't know how to explain this human. Basically, they claim to be a lesbian, but they have the facial structure of a man. They are built like a man. They talk like a man. So, yeah. Well, anyways, most of us around here probably assume that a lesbian relationship involves two women. Now, I'm not sure what gender this thing identifies as. I actually left my dictionary of genders at home. Damn, that really sucks. I guess we'll just have to use man and woman for the rest of this video. So, yeah, I apologize. If I offend any of you, you know, you can write it on a piece of paper and wipe your ass with it, and I will never look at it, okay? Anyways, this person says, cis lesbians, this is 5 reasons why you should date me, a trans woman.
Hi, lesbians of TikTok. This is 5 reasons why you should date me, a trans woman. This will no longer be you. Here you go. If we decide to have kids, it can be genetically both of ours because I have swimmers frozen.
Alright, man. I knew you were fucked up in the head. You were a weird motherfucker whenever I first looked at you, but now, like, I've got all the proof, man. This seals the goddamn deal. Like, this is what doesn't make sense to me, right? You are a man one day, and then the next day you want to claim to be a woman, and then you want to get into a lesbian relationship, which means you have to adopt or don't have kids. Like, that's your 2 fucking options, alright? But now you are claiming to be a woman with fucking frozen sperm in your goddamn fridge. Dude, that is disgusting, man. For the love of God, your kids eat out of that fucking freezer. Please get that out of there. Like, come on, man. How much longer are we really gonna let these alphabet plus people just keep pushing? Like, we're living in a fucking foo-foo bunny world. Like, I understand if you want to be a woman, you don't like being a man, okay? Maybe you have a tiny dick and you have all this extra room in your pants, which is very nice, you know, good for you. So you wake up one day and you decide, you know what? I think I'm gonna be a woman and I want to be in a relationship with a woman. So I'm gonna be a lesbian. It doesn't really fucking work like that though. The thing is, if you're gonna be a man dating a, like, this is so fucking difficult to explain. Basically what I'm trying to say here is, if you want to impregnate a woman, you are a man. This is a straight relationship. Like, there's just no lesbianism going on around here, you know what I'm trying to say? Like, I'm not trying to be some bully raining on the gay parade or anything, but you know, come on, man. Like, just admit it. You don't gotta say it to everyone. Just say it to me. You're straight. You're straight as fuck. Like, you're a man impregnating a woman. Like, how is that a lesbian relationship at all? That just, it doesn't fucking make sense to me, man. Like, and that's what my whole point of this fucking video is, alright? How much longer are we gonna play this goddamn game, alright? I'm fucking sick of it. I'm out, man. I'm out of room for genders. We've already got like 80 goddamn plus, minus, and any other gender you wanna be today. Like, I understand that this is probably a nice individual. They're a good person. They make good decisions. They just want to be recognized in a different way, and I understand that. But, no, I don't think I will. You see, the thing is, man, these people are always talking about how they're scarred from life because someone said they're a fucking idiot for what they do, you know, someone like me. I get it, okay? I honestly do. I understand someone said something mean a long time ago and you just can't fucking let it go. Whatever, right? Let's move on. Let's let go of the past. You know what would really scar me for life, though, is if I went out on a date with a woman, I take her home, we start to get into the sexual part of the night, I pull them pants off, and there's a goddamn fucking dick right there, okay? How the fuck am I gonna cope with something like that? Does anyone ever think of that? Does anyone ever think of me? Like, I'm sorry, bro, but I'm just not gonna look at your hairy fucking asshole and get turned on. It's just not gonna happen, man. You gotta let it go. Guys, I'm just saying, if you ever see one of these things out there in the wild, you gotta be very careful when you approach it, okay? Talk slowly, approach it slowly. Don't offend it. The last thing thing you want to do is fucking offend this thing. Next thing you know, you got a lawsuit on your hands, okay? I'd rather just get my ass kicked. Unfortunately, though, it doesn't work like that. They're gonna post all over social media. They're gonna try and call their local news station. All because you don't agree with their views. So, like I said, just be careful out there, fellas. It's a cold world. Anyways, guys, with all that being said, that's gonna be it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I want to give a shout out to the world's greatest fucking channel member of all goddamn time. Shout out to the homie Joseph. If you yourself would like to support the channel, consider becoming a member today. More importantly though, fellas, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you are new. Leave a like on the video if you want to support the hot moms with me. And I'll catch you guys next time. Later.
That if you are a good-hearted human, you will be treated like a goddess. Like a goddess.
Alright, what's going on everyone, and welcome back to another video. Fellas, today we're gonna be taking a look at your typical gamer girl who's all about good vibes and positivity. Listen, Cupcake, I know you might think the world revolves around Care Bears and unicorns and that kind of shit. Listen, alright, I'm sorry to be the bad guy, it doesn't though. Alright, so basically, man, I'm gonna be showing you guys a clip here in a couple seconds of a woman who's streaming some Halo Infinite, and apparently she sucks ass at the game. Like, she's really bad, she's weighing down the team, costing them lives. And so basically all that happens is two of her teammates decide to start talking some shit to her. And don't get me wrong, guys, I am all for some shit talking. You know, I do a little bit myself here and there. And like, that's just because when it comes to online gaming, talking shit is like, it's just part of it, man. It's part of the environment. Hell, especially if you're playing a first person shooter. In this case, she's playing Halo, which is rated M. You know, it's no different than Call of Duty. If you don't like this kind of thing, maybe you shouldn't play these fucking games, you know what I'm saying? Or here's an even better idea. They invented this new thing. Oh god, what do they call? Oh yeah, voice chat. You can disable it in the settings if you don't want to listen to your teammates. Turn it off. Oh my god, it's so crazy. It takes a goddamn rocket scientist to come up with that. Anyways, like I was saying, these are environments that you should expect to be put in when you're playing a game that is rated M. You know, this game is designed for people over the age of 18. However, you don't see me going into like Care Bear Simulator and trying to start shit in that game. How come these women want to come to our space where we're trying to play some fucking shooter games, a military simulator, and she wants to try and change our environment? I don't get it, man. It really doesn't make sense. I also want to point out, man, the insults that these teammates are using are fucking pathetic too. Like, they are bad. They're not insulting whatsoever. I can't believe she was actually about to cry over this shit. Anyways, guys, without wasting any more fucking time, if you enjoyed the video, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel, and let's get right into it.
Miss Cat, just fucking leave. Go play Fortnite or whatever the fuck.
Whatever you girls do, like play Valorant or something, get like 2 kills.
Yeah, show your tits on fucking Twitch, whatever.
Just get the fuck off of Halo, because you're not meant to be here.
Yeah, this is not for you. You notice how Master Chief was never a woman?
Alright, hopefully you guys can understand what I'm talking about now when I say these insults, they're fucking trash, man. All they're saying is like, go play Valorant and get 2 kills. Oh my god, what a fucking burn that was. And then when one of the guys said, isn't it time for you to show your tits on Twitch or something along those lines, dude, like, that's not insulting. I can't imagine crying over a statement like that. I mean, when it comes to the two guys trying to insult her, they kind of sound like fucking retards, bro. They sound stupid as hell. Their insults are pathetic. It comes nowhere close to, like, actually being insulting. Now, if they would have said something along the lines of, like, holy shit, your nose is fucking gigantic, I swear to god I could land a 747 plane on that. I mean, again, it's still really nothing to cry over, but at least, like, I could understand where you're coming from if you start to get a little teary-eyed. Anyways, man, that's why I recommend any of these gamer girls that just have feelings made of glass, you know, it's probably just best you stay on Animal Crossing, because that kind of seems to be more your type. And again, I honestly just don't understand why why you would almost start crying when some like 18-year-old high school loser says, "Shouldn't you be showing your tits on Twitch right now?" Like if someone came up to me and it was like, "Hey, Dr. Bolo, shouldn't you be out there showing your ding dong right about now?" I'd be like, "Yeah, man, you're probably right. I probably should be." We'd laugh it off. Day goes on. Nothing. I'm not fazed. Not even in the slightest. Listen, man, I hate to be the one to say this. I really do. But if you cannot handle a little criticism just like that, then streaming is probably not a good choice for you. You know, you might as well just sell the Elgato. Now, one thing I would like to mention is that just because you have a woman in your Call of Duty lobby doesn't mean you should tell her, "You know what, bitch, it's time for you to get down on your knees and let's take care of this." I mean, you shouldn't really do that, but I will say, I think we all know by now, gamer girls are just not fucking good at video games, man, alright? They do hold the team back, and I will say, if you're holding the team down, you're probably gonna be getting some in game chat. Honestly, though, that goes for anything you do in life. I mean, if you're playing basketball, you're being a fucking ball hog, missing all the shots, the coach is gonna come up to you and be like, "Dude, what the fuck are you doing out there, man? Pass the damn ball." Anyways, for those of you that are wondering, the guys that were harassing the woman in the clip, they actually reached out to her and said, "This is an apology from us for yesterday. We took it too far and are very sorry you were hurt by our words. We do feel bad and best of luck to you in life." Alright, so, what's the fucking issue now? I don't understand. They were mean, they apologized, and apparently this woman can't fucking accept their apology. She's still fucking pissed about it. She is still going on Twitter to this very day. I don't know, man. I'll honestly just never understand, because if someone said something quite mean to me in a Halo lobby, I'm not gonna lose any fucking sleep over it. All right, I'm gonna continue on with my life just like I was before I played that game of Halo. I mean, you guys know what they say. If you can't handle the heat, you better get out of the kitchen. And guys, with all that being said, that's going to be it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I want to give a shout out to my fucking fantastic members. We have Joseph and Dirt Grub. Guys, I appreciate the hell out of your support. It means everything to me. If you yourself would like to support the channel, consider becoming a member today. More importantly though, fellas, be sure to subscribe to the channel. If you are new, leave a like on the video if you want to support the Hot Moms with me. And I will catch you guys next time. Later.
I want Master Chief does not have a sexuality. It's in the books, okay? I've read the books.
That's probably something in the LGBT thing.
Virgin alert. I know that
you
virgin.
Read Halo books?
Wow. Yeah, dude. They were good too.
Fucking
wow.
Virgin.
To think I'm friends with you.
I know.
Alright, what's going on everyone, and welcome back to another video. Fellas, today we need to talk about the alphabet people. Things are just getting way too out of hand with them, and I'm just saying, man, pretty soon they're gonna have the rest of the letters on the LGBTQ+QRST community. You might as well just refer to them as the alphabet community, it's so much easier. Well anyways, the other day I was scrolling through Twitter, and I just so happened to see probably the stupidest shit I've ever seen in my lifetime, and you know who it comes from? This person right here. I mean, let's be completely honest. What did you expect? I mean, if we just take a quick look at her profile here, you guys are gonna see all sorts of red flags. Starting off, she's got the pronoun she, her. Yeah, whatever. I could give a less. She also claims to have a PhD in gender studies, all right? Not only is that the most useless fucking degree of all time, you got a goddamn doctorate in it, all right? And just because you're not a medical doctor doesn't mean you're a complete failure. I mean, if you had your doctorate's degree in like literature or physics, you're still going to contribute to society in a very good way. But like, if you have a degree in gender studies, what the hell are you gonna do with that? You're just gonna tweet out on Twitter, "Hey guys, you know what? I talked to someone with a penis today and they took a piss in the woman's restroom. Oh my God." All right, I will say I actually know a couple people that got a degree in gender studies, and you guys know what they're doing with their lives. They're bussing tables at restaurants. I mean, they're failures. I'm sorry. It's pathetic. Anyways, getting back on track here to Mrs. Alphabet Doctor herself. Another thing I'd like to point out, she has tips enabled on Twitter. All right, I just want to say anyone who has this option on their Twitter account is a fucking tool. They're a loser. You do not need any goddamn money for tweeting, okay? I can understand live stream. You're providing entertainment at that point. But anytime I see someone on Twitter that is asking for donations, I mean, it's honestly just fucking sad, all right? But if we go to her actual description here, it says, Head of Gender Studies at ACL University. Bigots for breakfast. 1/8 black, semi-trans, demisexual lesbian who dates men. What the fuck does that actually even mean, bro? So you're a lesbian who dates men and you have a doctorate's degree? This is kind of scary, man, okay? I don't know what college she went to get this degree, but I mean, they just gotta be handing them out at this point, right? Like, they just look on your Twitter profile and see if you have your pronouns in the bio and they're like, yep, okay, here, you can have a doctorate's degree. And you know what, guys? I honestly want to thank this woman for including in her profile that she's an 1/8 black, because I was, you know, I didn't know how I was gonna fucking sleep. And I was like, oh my god, there's no way this woman can be totally white and have a doctorate in gender studies. Like, bro, I guarantee she took one of them 23andMe tests and it came back as like, oh, you're 8% black. And then she's like, you know what, let's just round it up to 12.5% and I'll make sure that I'm inclusive to everyone. Like, whenever people do that, it just doesn't really make sense to me, because it's like, yeah, you're an 1/8 black, but what about the rest of their percentages? Are you going to include that too? Or, you know, is that not inclusive enough? And again, I wouldn't expect anything less from someone that looks like this and has a doctorate's degree in gender studies. Well, anyways, this woman or alphabet thing, you know, I don't want to include pronouns because they might change by the time the video actually goes live. So I'll just say this alphabet thing tweets out, well, my 6-year-old assigned female at birth, AFAB, has decided she is a girl. I am trying extremely hard not to misgender her aloud, but I confess I still call her Z and Zer in my mind. This will be a great opportunity to use the beta version of the upcoming Zap to Quit app. Listen, all I'm gonna say here, bro, is that I cannot fucking believe right now I share a goddamn planet with these fucking people. Get me the hell out of here, all right? Elon, I will be happy to volunteer to go to Mars, bro. I don't give a goddamn if I die. Get me the hell out of here. Well, I should say that offer is contingent upon all these stupid fucks are not going with me. Either we need to load these alphabet soup people and ship them on a goddamn spaceship out there to the red planet and we stay here, or we need to go, man. Something needs to happen. I can't believe I'm sharing the same fucking oxygen with this person. All right, so this is gonna hurt my brain, but let's break this tweet down. So she says that her 6-year-old daughter has decided she wants to be a girl. Again, she's fucking 6, dude. Most 6-year-olds, they can't read, they can't tell you their own street address, but somehow they have the mental capacity to decide their own gender nowadays. I mean, honestly, bro, this is just fucking sad at this point. You're trying to not misgender your own daughter who's 6 years old. I couldn't even imagine if, let's say I was a parent one day and I was asking you, I was like, oh, what color is your daughter's room? And this woman looks at me and says, oh, Z's room is red. I'm gonna do a fucking double take real quick and I'm gonna go, what the actual fuck did you just say to me? Like, bro, it's already bad enough we have to share a fucking planet with these kind of people, but just to make things even worse, just to put some fucking salt in my wounds right now, they have decided to repopulate. They have had some offspring and those kids are gonna grow up and want to know, like, all these fucking pronouns. They're gonna be pronoun proficient and all this other bullshit. I hate this, man. I fucking hate this. And I will say, I am glad to see this woman was getting flamed on Twitter. I mean, you know what? She kind of fucking deserves it. Call your daughter who she is, raise her right, and at least let her make the decision on what gender she wants to be when she's like 12 or 13, you know? When she actually has some brain power to fucking function in society, then let her make that decision. Not when she's a kid and you're gonna force it on her, though. And also, by the way, if you're not following me on Twitter, you're fucking missing out, alright? Click the link in the description below and make a life-changing decision today. Anyways, I was just glad to see that there were some people in the comment section that actually had some fucking common sense, okay? Todd Davis, the whitest name on the face of the fucking planet, says, I'm now convinced this is a troll account, and I want to commend you because you had me fooled for a very long time. Excellent job. Carry on. And the funny part about it is that's pretty much every reply she got. I didn't see anything that was like, oh my god, good job, you know, using the correct pronoun. I didn't see any of that bullshit. Anyways, guys, with all that being said, that's gonna be it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. And also, I got a new microphone. I didn't mention this in the last video. I mean, hopefully it doesn't sound like straight ass cheeks, but I thought I would just mention it in case anyone's like, hey man, your voice kind of sound like it changed a little bit. Yeah, my balls are still in the same place. It's just a new microphone, fellas. Anyways, I want to give a shout out to the two greatest fucking channel members on the face of the goddamn planet. We have Joseph and Dirt Grub. Guys, I appreciate the hell out of your support. It means everything to me. If you yourself would like to support the channel, consider becoming a member today. More importantly though, fellas, be sure to subscribe to the channel. If you are new, leave a like on the video if you want to support the MILFs with me, and I will catch you guys next time. Later. Alright, what's going on everyone, and welcome back to another video. Fellas, today we're gonna be talking about Patrick Mahomes' family once again. If I'm being completely honest here, I feel terrible for Patrick, because no matter how good he does on the football field, he also does a lot of great things in his community. He's going to come home to a family full of assholes. I mean, honestly though, I gotta give it to the man, because if I was in the NFL, I was out there pre-game, stretching, warming up, whatever, right? I look over on the sidelines, there's my brother doing some stupid fucking TikTok dance, you know, TikTok, I'ma sit on a cock later, like, we get it, Jackson, alright? We fucking get it, bro. Either way, man, it just seems like every week with these guys, they gotta do something to stay relevant in the media, you know, whether they're pouring water on fans, out here dancing on dead people's fucking memorials, they gotta do something, right? Because they all want their own fucking clout. And the craziest part of this whole situation is that they honestly have it made. They will never have to work another day in their life. No matter what restaurant they want to go to in Kansas City, they're paying the Patrick price. Patrick's brother Jackson and his wife Brittany honestly just have to do one thing in their lifetime, and that is just stay the fuck out of trouble. And now that I think about it, they really do have all the clout in the world, you know? If they wanted to take the Lambo out to lunch, I'm sure Patrick would be fine with it. But what's even better than driving a Lambo to go get some lunch is not having to pay for that car to go get your lunch. Well, anyways, after I just said a lot of bad things about this family, and you know, I'm not gonna deny it, Jackson is a stupid fuck, okay? Every time he walks on the field, I have a fucking heart attack. Anyways, I guess it was Brittany's turn to be blasted in the media this week, and I'm not gonna say this very often, but I don't really think she deserved it. Before I show you guys that clip, if you happen to enjoy today's video, please be sure to leave a like on it and subscribe to the channel, and without wasting any more time, let's get into it. So what you guys just watched was basically Brittany Mahomes dousing all the fucking peasants down below her in some champagne. I mean, popping a bottle of champagne and spraying it all over the crowd is usually something that's pretty standard in sports nowadays. Anyways, I guess there was a lot of window lickers out there this weekend that were just pissed. Like, they were fuming at the fact that she sprayed these people below her with champagne. Like, look at this person right here. She says, "I understand wanting to celebrate the win, but this is completely disrespectful to the fans who may not drink, have small children there, are former alcoholics. I know it might be a hard ask, but please try to have a little bit of class during the next game. This is so trashy." Alright, so I don't know what this woman's issue is. Maybe she's just having a hard time getting laid because, you know, she suffers from, like, dry pussy syndrome or something like that. Here, you know what? Hang on, I can help you. You've been prescribed a fucking hoe, bitch. God damn, that felt so good, man. My hand was sitting there, it was just twitching like it was fucking ready to write that goddamn prescription. Anyways, you're still a hoe. But guys, that doesn't change the fact that, like, at the end of the day, Brittany was just trying to celebrate one of the biggest
biggest wins in football. And I mean, if we just take a look at the crowd below her, everyone's cheering. Everyone's pumped. Like, they're fucking ecstatic at this point. I don't see anyone down there like, no, Britney, please. Now, if we're being completely honest here, I am sure there was at least one person down there in the crowd that did not want to get sprayed with champagne. And to that, I have to say, tough shit. Who fucking cares? Like, you're still in the playoffs, you know? Your dream is still alive at this point. Now, it would be one thing if it was the actual parents that got sprayed on Twitter saying like, hey, fuck you, Britney. You soaked me and my kid and it was fucking cold out. I hate you. If that was the case, I suppose I could have a little bit of sympathy, but like, it's not. You know what I'm saying? The people who are pissed at her online weren't even the ones getting sprayed by champagne. I don't know, man. It's just funny because most of the people fucking complaining, like, probably have never been to an actual football game in their life, and definitely not one of this magnitude. You know what I'm saying? Like, they may have just went to some fucking preseason game. They're definitely the type of people to leave by the third quarter, no matter how good the game is. And you know what, man? Like, they just got a fucking stick in their ass. I don't know how else to say it. What I will say, though, is that Jackson Mahomes is really just a glorified douchebag, and Britney is really not much better. You know, just a little bit, a cunt hair above Jackson, but not much, man. Definitely not much. Either way, what she did here in this situation, I really just don't see anything wrong with it. I mean, just face it, that bottle of champagne never fucking stood a chance, bro. It was getting popped one way or another, and what was she supposed to do? Like, point down there in the crowd and say, sir, are you okay if I pop this bottle? All right, ma'am, are you okay if I... Like, no, you can't fucking expect that. You could try and make an argument of, oh, Dr. Bolo, she should have just never popped the bottle of champagne in the first place. And you know what? If that's the case, the bottle of champagne should have been opened in your fucking ass. Well, anyways, with all that being said, that's gonna be it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I want to give a shout out to the world's greatest fucking channel member of all time. His name is fucking, or excuse me, I don't want to misgender anyone here. Their name is Joseph the fucking GOAT. If you would like to support the channel yourself, consider becoming a member today. More importantly though, fellas, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you are new. Leave a like on the video if you want to support the hot moms with me, and I will catch you guys next time. Later. Alright, what's going on everyone, and welcome back to another video. Fellas, today we're gonna be taking a look at a expert in the act of doing it. You know what I'm saying here? We're before 30 seconds in the video, so I can't say the S word. Well, anyways, the expert in intimacy is, she's not happy, bro, okay? Especially with the black community. She's pissed. I'm sorry. Although she sounds very, very stupid in this clip, I gotta give it to her. She at least had the balls to go on a TV show and try and propose some stupid shit like this. Like, if someone ever came up to me and said, hey man, you know what, you should go on Dr. Phil and try to explain to him that we've been doing it wrong this whole time. You're supposed to take a shit standing up and take a piss sitting down. Like, it sounds funny in the moment, you know, you could say like, oh, maybe I could get that stupid fucking bald guy with the caterpillar under his nose to, you know, bite at a couple points here and there. But like, when it comes time to actually going on the TV show and trying to sound retarded but at the same time smarter than everyone else, that's pretty difficult, bro. That is something I could definitely not pull off. Well, anyways, like I mentioned earlier, this woman claims to be an expert with everything inside the bedroom. She went out here on a TV show and said, black people are too comfortable using disturbing language like, I'ma beat that pussy up, I'ma murder the pussy. So yeah, I guess she doesn't really appreciate that kind of language, but one thing I do appreciate is you guys subscribing to the channel. I mean, hell, fuck it. If one day you want to beat the pussy up yourself, go ahead, subscribe to the channel. Your chances to beat up some puss increase by like 100x, so you have a good chance of getting laid. But I mean, if you look like this guy, bro, there ain't nothing, okay? There ain't a goddamn thing I could do for you, all right? Anyways, without wasting any more time, let's get into it.
Why are you trying to murder me? I want to be very, very clear. The language by which we talk about sex in black communities is disturbing. We talk about, oh, I'm finna beat it up. I'm gonna shoot up the club. I'm gonna shoot up the club.
I mean, maybe I'm the odd man out here, but I've never heard someone refer to getting laid as I'm going to blank up the club right now. Like, if that's the case, then I think this guy who I just mentioned earlier, he can't get any puss, right? Like, he's tried everything. Now he's down to his last resort. He's coming back to the club, and it's going to be bad. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I don't really know about that one, bro, but let's go on to see what else she has to say.
Why are we using violent language to describe an intimate act?
Okay. I don't know. I want him to murder the pussy.
Do you guys know what this face right here says? This face tells you everything you need to know, all right? I don't even need to hear words come out of her mouth. This is telling me I fucked up. I look like a goddamn lunatic now. And to be fair, you do. You do look like a fucking idiot right now, and everyone on television and YouTube has just seen that. I mean, don't get me wrong. It was really cute and thoughtful of you to put together like this homemade model of a fucking vag and bring it with you to this presentation. Like, I honestly can't believe you put that thing together and brought it with you and actually told yourself, like, yeah, this is gonna get people to take me seriously. You know, something I just thought of that I think is honestly pretty important right now, who in the fuck gave her the title of an intimacy expert? Cause I'm just saying, bro, if she's an expert on everything that goes on within the bedroom, then I'm an expert on like fucking purses, hair, and nails and some shit. And you know what, man, sometimes you gotta read the room and realize when to say stuff and when not to. Like, for instance, if you went to school and you were talking to your principal and like mid-conversation you're just like, oh, by the way, dude, I beat the fuck out of this pussy last night, it's probably not gonna go good from that point on. You know what I'm saying? Like even though you might think that and you want to tell your principal about it, you probably shouldn't. And that's kind of the same scenario here. You might have done a little better on like a grandma TV show. You know what I'm talking about. Like one of those shows where they talk highly of knitting and they talk down upon kids that listen to their music too loud. Like that would be a good place to do this presentation because no one there is going to deny it. They're going to be like, mm-hmm, yes, girl, go ahead and preach. And you know why? That's because they're not getting laid anymore, man. Like they just can't keep up to date in the new world. They can't adapt. Honestly, I just can't get past the fact that she got the title of being an expert. Like, is that a self-proclaimed expert? You know what I'm saying? Because the only people that should really be an expert on all things bedroom talk would be like Riley Reid or Johnny Sins, you know, something like that. Those people, they got a little bit of expertise in the industry. This woman, what the fuck is she contributing? Nothing, bro. She's out here with her grapefruit vagina trying to convince us this language is harmful. Oh well, I guess she'll have to find something else to complain about next time. And guys, with all that being said, that's gonna be it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I want to give a shout out to the world's greatest fucking channel member, Joseph. If you yourself would like to support the channel, consider becoming a member today. More importantly though, fellas, be sure to subscribe to the channel. If you are new, leave a like on the video if you want to support the hot moms with me, and I will catch you guys next time. Later.
Oh, no. Shit.
How did that dude not kill me?
198.
Hey,
imagine getting an entire regiment online.
Got 100.
Imagine being so good at the game, like you fucking losers.
Incoming army,
watch out. That could simply never be me. Dog,
like your mom. Army, shut up. Watch out.
Stop talking. No one asked you. You're 0-3. You're a loser. Be quiet.
I can't even fucking understand what the hell he's saying.
I know, and I love it.
What's going on, everyone, and welcome back to another video. Fellas, today we're gonna be talking about the beef between Pokimane and Jidion. And you know what, man, I wasn't even gonna make a video on this topic because like it's honestly so stupid. Like I honestly hate that I even called it a beef because really it's not, and it's not at all, man. It's just like two toddlers trying to fist fight each other. Anyways, I'm sure most of you are aware of what's happened in this situation, but just to quickly summarize it, one day Jidion was streaming on Twitch, and he decided to raid Pokimane and have his subscribers spam in the chat L plus ratio or plus you're a woman, you know, some stupid shit like that. The fact that an L plus ratio raid is the same thing as like a hate raid on Twitch, like that's just bullshit, in my opinion. If Gideon sent his subscribers to make fun of her culture, her skin color, or you know, maybe just because she's fat or something, I don't know, man. I could at least kind of understand where you're coming from, but an L plus ratio, like, come on, man. That's gotta be the softest hate raid of all fucking time. Anyways, continuing on here, so she gets raided by Gideon, you know, all this shit goes down. She gets upset in her feelings, ends her stream. She then goes to Twitch, complains. Gideon gets banned off of Twitch. Boom, gone. No longer allowed to stream. After that, things went to Twitter, and that's when everything just got blown like way out of proportion. Like Ninja got involved and he was threatening his lawyers, and it was, the whole situation is just absolutely insane from spamming L plus ratio. I mean, honestly, at what point do we draw the line and say like, come on, Cupcake, just grow a fucking pear. You know what I'm saying? It's not that bad. No one was insulting you. Although it went down in Pokimane's chat, it wasn't meant to be like a personal attack, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't meant to be like malicious in any way. Like when I saw all this going down, dude, I was just sitting there scratching my head like, come on,
nigga.
Well, anyways, after all of that went down, Gideon, like any normal person, would be like, this is fucking bullshit. It wasn't meant to be harmful. At first, I'm pretty sure he was trying to fight the whole situation, and then it's like things just did a complete U-turn, and now Pokimane has this man bent the fuck over, and she's about 8 inches deep inside his asshole. I mean, just look at this right here. Pokimane tweets out, I'm glad he apologized and told his viewers to chill. Hope he does better in the future, and that this will be the last time I have to talk about this. And then Gideon tweets out, your typical response, you know, I'd expect this from someone who's getting fucking cucked. He tweets out, happy you heard my apology, Pokimane, and I will do better. Keep having an amazing career. I hate that I'm even saying this, bro, but Pokimane has got her way once again. Like, I swear to God, over there at Twitch headquarters, Pokimane's got every man by the balls right now, and she's just getting whatever the hell she wants. This is probably gonna piss off a lot of the Pokimane simps and cucks down there, but guess what, man? Pokimane, she's not that attractive. If anything, she's a cunt hair above average. I just don't get it. I don't understand why all these people are bowing down to her like she's some sort of fucking actual goddess or anything. Well, anyways, it keeps getting worse, fellas. Gideon tweeted out on January 30th, to my boys, I appreciate y'all, and I know y'all think what you're doing is helping, but it's only causing more problems. Please, leave Pokimane alone and just drop it, because I've moved on and y'all should too. If you rock with me, you'll listen. Thanks. Like, I swear to God, bro, Gideon gotta be in Pokimane's DMs right now. Like, goddess, please, no! Don't ban me from the kingdom! I don't know, man. I just don't get it. And if I'm being completely honest here, I like Gideon. I think he's funny. He makes decent content. But I'm not gonna lie, after all of this middle school drama, like, I have kinda lost a little bit of respect for him. Now he's bowing down. Like I said, he's straight up taking a dong in his butthole from Pokey at night. I'm just saying here, man, if this is the best beef that happens in 2022, then we're fucked. We're absolutely fucked. It's gonna be a long ass year. And you know what? Just to add some fuel to the fire, as of today, Pokimane's contract with Twitch has expired. But I mean, let's be real. I don't know why the hell she wouldn't re-sign with Twitch. They give her fucking everything. Like, literally anything that woman wants, they just bow down and kiss her fucking toes, each one by one. So if I had to take a pretty good guess here, I'd assume Twitch is just literally gonna back up a fucking dump truck full of cash in front of her house and just drop it right there for her. Cause I don't know why they wouldn't re-sign her. She's one of the most famous streamers over there. And anytime you see like a Twitch advertisement, Pokimane is always like the first person you see on it. But anyways, to summarize the whole situation here, I think it's stupid. It's fucking pathetic. Gideon has bowed down to Pokimane. Like I said, he's taking it in the butt from her. I don't know what else you want from the man. He admits that he messed up. He just wants his account back so he can get back to streaming. Anyways, guys, with all that being said, said, that's gonna be it for today's video. Thank y'all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I want to give a shout out to the world's greatest fucking channel members of all goddamn time. We have Joseph and Dirt Grub. Guys, I appreciate the hell out of you. Your support means everything to me. If you yourself would like to support the channel, consider becoming a member today. But more importantly, fellas, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you are new. Leave a like on the video if you want to support the Hot Moms with me, and I will catch you guys next time. Later. All right, what's going on, everyone, and welcome back to another video. Fellas, today we're going to be taking a look at possibly the greatest competition I've ever seen in my lifetime. We're going to watch two fat dudes go at it to see who's the better Discord mod. Now, I'm sure most of you know that Discord mods are not necessarily like the highest people in society. Like, they're kind of the scum of the earth, all right? I'm just being completely honest here. They can be fat or they can be skinny, you know? It really comes down to, like, whether they're so heavily invested into e-girls, warlocks, and fedoras and shit like that. Anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and spoil some things for you. So basically, we're gonna be taking a look at a Call of Duty tournament that someone recorded on their phone. And as you can imagine, a little bit of shit talk starts going on, really between these two Teletubby looking fellas. Like, don't get me wrong, I'm all for some shit talk, especially when it comes to a game like Call of Duty. I mean, hell, the game is rated M. You have to be, what, 17 or 18? To even purchase the game. I think it should just be expected that at some point in time while you're playing a game of Call of Duty, someone is probably going to try and talk some shit to you. They might even say something to get you big fucking mad. Like, I'm honestly surprised they're not legally required to say something like that on the box of Call of Duty when you buy it. Anyways, I think you guys will see when I show you the clip here in a minute that they may have won the game of Call of Duty, but the only real winner here in the room is Diabetes, okay? And don't get me wrong, there are definitely some people there that are not morbidly obese. It just so happens that the three Discord mods that are about to go after it, you know, they kind of fit the criteria. I mean, it almost had me wondering, like, when you go to an amusement park and you want to ride a roller coaster, it's like, oh, you must be 72 inches tall to ride this ride. I was really wondering, like, do you have to weigh like 350 pounds at a minimum to talk shit at these places or what? But anyways, if you guys happen to enjoy today's video, please be sure to subscribe to the channel and leave a like on the video. And without wasting any more goddamn time, let's get into it. You know what's kind of funny is if I showed this clip right here without the sound, you'd probably think they're having the most fucking intense match of rock, paper, scissors you could ever see. Well, there's that. Now, from what I understand, this is actually, like, pretty standard at these Call of Duty tournaments. I also have seen videos of dudes, like, getting up out of their chair, walking over to the enemy team, and actually screaming, like, 6 inches from their fucking face. How is there not more fights in this environment? Especially when the other team is getting up out of their seat and clapping in your face. Bro, how do you not just fucking swing on them at that point? Even if you are a little chubby, bro, like, you just gotta pretend that man is a fry cook and he just fucked up your burger and it's time to go to town on him. I will say, I am just glad to see that no one was wearing any t-shirts that has like food brands on it, for instance Hot Pockets or Taco Bell. Cause I can't even lie, bro, if someone the shape of a blueberry was coming after me with like a Hot Pockets t-shirt on, there is no way I could take him seriously. And you know, something else I just thought of, I am so glad that there are people who actually record these events like on their phones and shit. There is not a chance in hell I would ever walk into a Call of Duty tournament. That's just not the environment for me. Like, obviously, look at the people you're going to be associated with. I understand that this is probably your ideal look for a Call of Duty athlete, but I'm just saying, man, if I walk in the room and I see this going on, I'd say it's probably best I just turn my happy ass around and go find a different bar. And guys, with all that being said, that's going to be it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I want to give a shout out to the world's greatest fucking channel members of all time. We have Joseph and Dirt Grub. Guys, I appreciate the hell out of your your support. It means everything to me. If you yourself would like to support the channel, consider becoming a member today. More importantly though, fellas, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you are new. Leave a like on the video if you want to support the hot moms with me, and I will catch you guys next time. Later. Alright, what's going on everyone, and welcome back to another video. Fellas, today we're going to be talking about an OnlyFans model that got a very weird text message from her uncle. Now, I will say, I personally don't know anyone in my life that has an OnlyFans, and you know, most of the time it's like that for a reason. However, if my uncle found out I was posting some booty pics online, I'd just kill me, bro. Just take me out. Anyways, the model that we're going to be talking about today goes by the name of Carly Brooks. Now, it's actually a possibility you've heard her name before. Like, don't get me wrong, she's definitely an OnlyFans model, but if you type her name in on Google, you're gonna get a lot more than just some OnlyFans. And as always, before I ever record one of my videos, I always like to be pretty well informed on the topic I'm talking about, so I did a little bit of my own behind the scenes research, and I gotta say, man, it was pretty good, don't get me wrong, but if I was her uncle, I still don't know if I'd be sending this text message. So anyways, if you guys happen to enjoy today's video, please be sure to leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and without wasting any more time, let's get right into it. So here's the text message I've been talking about. He says, "Hey kiddo," which is never really a great thing to say to someone who is in the adult industry. If you're ever using the word kiddo, it's just... no, just fucking don't, man. "This is your uncle. I think I might have stumbled across a video of you today. Very nice. Do you happen to know Riley Reed? Also, do you have an OnlyFans? My friend wants to know." My fucking God, dude. How many red flags can there be in one single text message? Just a couple sentences. So obviously, I pointed out the first thing where he addresses her as kiddo. I wouldn't associate anything with taking it in the booty hole and kids. It's just not really a good mix. Next, he describes her work as very nice, and even if it might be nice and wonderful and some beautiful art, that's not really the way I would describe it if I was her uncle. And I mean, like, what's really crazy is the uncle, he could have stopped there and waited for a reply, but instead he's like, no, now's my chance, I'm all in, I might as well ask her if she knows Riley Reed, as if, like, she's gonna tell Riley and she's gonna come over to your house and jerk you the fuck off. Then he tries to wrap up the message by asking if she has an OnlyFans and pinning it on his fucking friend, man. You can't even make this up if you tried. Like, the family dinners, Thanksgiving, all that shit, it's not gonna be the same, man. I mean, I don't know if the weird uncle and Carly are still gonna show up to Christmas with each other, but I'm just saying Carly might be opening a new kind of toy on Christmas. Listen, all I'm gonna say is that someone works at the FBI and they literally get paid to find people like this shit. Bro, I guarantee her uncle just hangs out at playgrounds and the moms probably come up to him and, you know, "Hey, which one's your kid?" And you, "Oh, I don't have a kid here. I'm just watching." You know, man, I'm really trying to put myself in the uncle's shoes right now and understand his point of view, because I get it. It's a weird subject. It's kind of something, it's difficult to bring up no matter how you look at it. But like, bro, this is a grown ass man who typed this message out, read it back to himself, and said, "Yeah, I think this is good to go," and he actually hit send. I mean, I don't know, man, maybe I'm the crazy one here, but I'm just saying, if I stumbled upon my niece's OnlyFans, I think the best thing to do is just not bring it up, you know? It's just not really a good situation to be in. Like, no matter how you phrase it, it's never going to come out comfortably, you know? Like, how do you talk to someone about getting piped in the ass for a living and just, it's normal? It's just normal talk. The only thing that would have made this story better is if we could have just got like some sort of context, you know, preferably a picture of the uncle. That way we could get an idea, you know, maybe he's just a grass mowing machine or shit, what do I know? Maybe he's a fucking doctor, he's just weird. I don't know, man. It would have been nice to have a little bit of context. Alright, so I was actually about to start wrapping up the video, but I was like, man, I feel like there's something missing to this story. So I went back out on Google, typed in Carly Brooks, and look what popped up. Hesitant niece Carly Brooks fucks her hot uncle. Well, now it all makes sense. Her uncle definitely found that video, bro, and he was punching the fucking air whenever he found out it wasn't him. He's like, are you fucking kidding me? That's my goddamn niece? Anyways, guys, with all that being said, that's gonna be it for today's video. Thank y'all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I want to give a shout out to the world's greatest fucking channel members. We have Joseph and Dirt Grub. Guys, I appreciate your support. If you yourself would like to support the channel, consider becoming a member today. More importantly, though, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you are new. Leave a like on the video if you want to support the Hot Moms with me, and enjoy this new outro, and I'll catch you guys next time. Later.
Right, and just don't just be nice to girls just because you want to date them. Okay, be nice to girls because you're a nice person.
Bye, I love you. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for all your support and watching. One, and welcome to my stream.
Oh my god, man, the amount of current. Why do I do this to myself? Well, anyways, what's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another video. Fellas, today we're going to be reacting to a Nicolol video. So basically, she has this series on her channel where she roasts, and I use that word very, very lightly, because you guys will see there's not really a whole lot of roasting going on. So basically, what happened is a bunch of people, they go in Nicolol's chat, and they say some stuff that might be crossing the line. They get banned, and then they can put in an appeal as kind of a, I'm sorry, I learned my lesson, please unban me. And so that's what we're going to be taking a look at today. But I mean, like, to be fair, what do you really expect? Her calling in life is to just sit in front of a camera and try and look halfway decent while a bunch of 13-year-olds try and type with their left hand. Anyways, guys, if you happen to enjoy today's video, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel. And if this video does well, you know what? Fuck it. I'll just make it a series on my channel too.
What size Snorlax is that? Nico, shut up. What size Snorlax is that? Please. What size Snorlax is that? This was a whole day later. He was like, what size is that? Please. You're washed. Did nothing. Listen, chef, I might be washed. All right. Okay. Some people might even call me washed low. Okay. But I'm still not going to tell you what size that Snorlax is. So at the end of the day, who's losing?
All right. Now, this one is actually kind of funny. So first off, his name is Chef Harambe. Great name. Great name. All right. RIP. Never forget. Second, I think it's hilarious how mad Nicolol is getting because someone is coming to her stream and not watching it for her. Instead, he's there because he wants to know the size of the Snorlax in the background. And I think it's freaking hilarious the fact that he just progressively gets more and more pissed off whenever she does not tell him the size of that fucking Snorlax. Like, he really came into the chat just kindly asking, hey, Nicolol, what size is that Snorlax in the background? And she never answered him, so he just got more and more pissed off, and he left by saying, shut the fuck up, you stupid bitch, what size is that Snorlax? And the fact that it made Nicolol mad just makes it that much funnier. Anyways, on to the next one. Alright, well, I honestly can't believe that Nicolol just skipped over this one, because this is a gold mine right here. So this guy Dean pops in chat and says, stand up and bend over, please. Alright, Dean's here. He ain't wasting no goddamn time, okay? Dean is on a time crunch right now. Boom, he gets hit with a timeout. He comes back another day. He says, I can't stop staring at them, man. I've been staring at him for the past 30 minutes straight. No cap. Well, Dean must be a very busy man because he doesn't waste any fucking time when he comes to these streams, all right? And he's gonna let you know how he feels. He might be the most honest person on the face of the planet. Sometimes that's great. And sometimes in cases like this, it doesn't really work out in your favor. Because then he comes back like 2 weeks later and says, move the cup, can't see. Move the fucking cup, I can't see him. Yeah, you know, I think Dean could use a little help when it comes to talking to chicks.
Okay, so you were a normal chatter, all right? First of all, Rockstar is superior, okay? But you were just a normal chatter, all right? You were normal. What happened? Frick, I just came. What are you saying? You were doing just fine. What kind of horny demon got into you?
Man, you know what? That's actually really crazy because it's almost as if people watch you because you're just slightly attractive. And not because you have a good personality, not because you're funny or entertaining. Instead, they just want to watch you dance around in some skimpy little outfit while they touch their dong. Like, come on, Nico. At least have a little bit of a goddamn brain. Also, I want to point out, this guy is smooth as fuck, bro. Look at the ban appeal he typed. He said, I didn't mean as in I was ejaculating. I meant it as in I just came into the chat. That man is smooth.
Listen, I believe it, actually. Because if you see this, if you see all his previous history, he seems like a he, she, okay? They.
Oh, what the fuck? Nico, the hell is your issue? Like, how are you gonna get mad because someone wants to know how big your Snorlax is? But at the same time, it's alright for you to come out here on stream and just misgender the people that support you the most. Alright guys, I need to make a statement real quick. So when Nicole makes these kind of videos, usually she tries to like roast these people. I mean, it never goes well. It's usually a pretty sad and pathetic attempt at roasting someone. But anyways, Nicolo didn't really do any of that in this video, alright? She basically just read from a screen, and that was pretty much it. So here is her best roast of the video I could find, and I'm not really gonna react to it because I think you guys will see it's pretty fucking elementary.
No offense, don't you guys just see through her fake persona she's putting on, though? She's a fake. Listen, dude, if you're mad that I am happier than you, if you're mad because your streaming career probably stayed at one average viewer for 3 years, just say that. The fact that you're so obsessed with my weight is fan behavior, you know? If you're a fan, just say that, you know?
Well, anyways, there you guys have it. I think we all pretty much learned the same thing here, and that is, Nicolol, not really funny, not really entertaining. And if I were to give you some advice, I would just say, you know, maybe instead of titling the video Roasting My Ban Appeals, maybe just title it Reading My Ban Appeals. That's a little more fitting. And you know, I just want to end the video by saying, I'm sure Nicolol is a nice person. Maybe she has a great personality or something. I don't really fucking know, nor do I care. But this video was kind of ass. I can't even lie. I'm pretty sure I fell asleep halfway through it. Oh well, I'm sure she'll be back with an episode 3, and then we will too. So anyways, guys, that's going to be it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I want to give a shout out to the world's greatest fucking channel members. We have Joseph and Dirt Girl. Guys, I appreciate the hell out of your support. It means everything to me. If you yourself would like to support the channel, consider becoming a member today. More importantly though, fellas, more importantly here, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you're new. And if you like hot moms, you might as well just leave a like on the video too, because you know what? Fuck it. Why not? Anyways, yeah, that's it. All right, goodbye.
Bye. Love you. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for all your support and watching. And you guys are amazing.
Alright, what's going on everyone, and welcome back to another video. Fellas, I gotta get something off my chest today, alright? I have been holding this back for quite some time now, and I just can't do it anymore, man. I just can't do it. I am just so sick and tired of going on Twitch at night because, you know, that's when all the creatures come out and they decide to start streaming. It's the best time to be on the website, in my opinion. So anyways, I'm on Twitch browsing through different streamers, and I run into an e-girl. I take a look at her profile picture, and I'm like, damn, okay, she might be kind of hot. I click on the stream, next thing you know, I am hit with a fucking ray of sunshine. It's almost as if God himself just jizzed in my eyeballs and didn't want me to see what I was supposed to be seeing, if you get what I'm saying here. Here, let me give you an example. Alright, so I apologize that there's a giant play button in the middle of the picture. I don't know any better way to, like, make the picture bigger on Twitch. Alright, so take a look at this picture right here. At least for me, you know, I get everyone's got a little bit of different taste, but personally, I see a cute blonde girl. She looks really hot. She looks good, right? I go in her stream. This is what I'm looking at. Now, obviously, no disrespect to this woman or anything. I'm not trying to personally attack her, but I am just kind of saying, saying, like, what the fuck? Where did we go wrong? Like, what actually happened? How did you go from a solid 10 down to like a 2.5? This doesn't make any goddamn sense. Fellas, this right here is why it's always a good reason to take a girl out on a swimming date. First off, you get to see him in like a bikini, right? That's always a good thing. But it's also really hard to wear makeup in a swimming pool, so you get a good idea of what you're actually gonna be working with. And like I said, no disrespect to this woman or anything, I'm sure she's a great person, but I just don't understand how you can step down like that fucking far. I get in your profile picture, you want to use the photo that's got the best lighting, you know, your skin looks the best in it, whatever, right? I understand, but what I don't understand is how you're going to look that good in a profile picture and then just absolutely bum it the fuck up when you're actually streaming. This whole situation honestly reminds me of a time I had on a dating app like a long time ago. So obviously I matched with this chick, she was really freaking hot, I thought things were going fantastic. And then we met up in person, and I'm like, did you fucking eat the girl I was supposed to meet up with? Cause where the hell is she? The thing is, man, this happened 6 times in a row. 6 times! I clicked on a profile picture thinking the girl was gonna be really fucking hot. I go into her stream, and she's really fucking not. I mean, here's another one right now. I just went on Twitch in the middle of this fucking commentary. Here's what she looks like in the profile pic. Here's what she looks like on stream at the moment. Now, I know there's gonna be someone out there that tries to make the argument, well, Doc, like, what if she just got off work, man? She's tired. She's trying to relax and play some video games. I mean, that's fine. You can be a bum and play some games all you want. Like, I don't care. I wonder if Stephen A cares.
I'm here to tell you right now, we don't care.
Yeah, I figured he wasn't gonna care. Listen, the point I'm trying to make, I just don't fucking appreciate being catfished all the time. And like I mentioned earlier, it's nothing personal against these two women I've just given examples of in this video. I mean, it's just fucking business at the end of the day. They all fucking do it. I mean, really, they're all out here trying to exploit their looks for some views online. And if you think I'm fucking lying, go find a girl streaming Warzone right now without a face cam. Go ahead. Go fucking ahead. I'll wait. Anyways, yeah, I'm sick of getting catfished, but at the end of the day, man, what it really comes down to is laziness. Like, the way I see this situation, it's pretty much the equivalent of clicking on like a dude stream and like his bed's not made, he's got trash all over the floor, hell, he's got shit stained underwear hanging off his fan. I mean, it's just, it's disgusting is what it is. It's not appeasing, it's not something someone wants to watch. And really, if you think about it, I'm just trying to be a father figure. I mean, you guys know I'm a doctor. I like to help people. And these women, they were given the greatest gift of all time. And that is boobs. You can use your boobs to get some views. It's incredible. Like, if a man gets into streaming and he wants to try and look good while he's streaming, you know, he's got to eat right, he's got to go to the gym, he's got to get proper lighting and all this other crap. For a girl, like, dudes don't fucking care. If they see a little bit of cleavage, they're happy. That's it. And I know there's going to be someone out there that tries to make the argument of, well, these people just stream for fun. And while that might be the case, I mean, I make videos for fun, but no one ever looks at like a video they posted on YouTube and they're like, oh, this video got 100,000 views? Are you fucking kidding me? That's bullshit. It was only supposed to get 15. Like, no, that's never been a thing. No one's ever gotten pissed at YouTube because their video got more views than what they were expecting it to get. Anyways, I'm just saying, and I'm gonna end the video on this. A little bit of effort goes a long way. And guys, with all that being said, that's gonna be it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I wanna give a shout out to the world's greatest fucking members, Joseph and Dirt Grub. Guys, I appreciate the hell out of your support. It means everything to me. If you yourself would like to support the channel, consider becoming a member today. But more importantly, fellas, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you're new. Leave a like on the video if you wanna support the MILFs with me, and I will catch you guys next time. Later.
Right, and just don't just be nice to girls just because you want to date them. Okay, be nice to girls because you're a nice person.
Bye, I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for all your support and watching.